Hey, there we go. Hello, everybody. Hello, hello, hello. There we go. Hey, listen, I'm a little thrown off, okay? I'm a little thrown off because I got up super late off of my Roll For It stream that I did just a little bit ago because it was the last session from the campaign that we're in. It's like, oh, a little frantic, but it's all good now. We're all here, right? Yes?
Yeah,
Awesome.
made it.
Awesome. Hello, everybody. So, everybody have a good week?
Yeah.
Yes.
Awesome. Ollie, how was your week? You're on vacation this week. You know what I mean? So you must
No,
feel
no, no, no,
relaxed.
no.
Or
He's on holiday.
oh, I'm sorry.
I'm on
You're on
holiday.
holiday.
Come on.
Oh,
I'm on
all
holiday.
day. All day.
I
Can't
you
be
want
on
to
a
know what's
holiday.
worse? Yeah, the way that
Silly.
like my brother spelled it was that.
Oh,
It's
it's holiday.
Oh, I like it.
Aw. How cute. How
I've done
cute.
nothing but like play Switch and watch like cooking shows, and it's been great.
Oh, well,
It's
that's
most of
great.
what I do when I've got free time, I guess.
Yeah, no, that's
That's
great. I watch cooking shows
legit.
anyway.
That's legit.
Yeah, let's see if I can fix my own mic because apparently I'm having a little bit of issues. So, I believe somebody else here is on holiday as well. Tell us how's that going?
I've been so busy this week. Just a struggle. No one understands.
Nice.
But no, we've been working with Penny. Her training is going along pretty nicely.
What's a penny?
Penny's my puppy. She's
What?
14 weeks. She's super cute.
Wait, so you got a dog?
Yeah.
Are you
You
sure?
wanna see her?
I mean,
It's
she
a
got
she's a
Damn.
dog.
She got a
She's a
thing.
dog. She's a dog.
Sure.
Over here.
If you say
Come
so.
here.
She's under a sheet. Like a parrot.
She
It's because she
will cry.
She will.
I'm not holding her.
Okay, there we go. My volume shouldn't be peaking anymore. Did you? Oh, there it is. There's the penny. Aw. Aw, how cute. Okay.
He's so cute.
Awesome. So you're enjoying your vacation as well. I'm glad to hear it.
I
And
am.
Eric, you're back to the grinds this week. How was that?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's work. It's work.
Okay,
You
well.
gotta do it. Get paid.
And nobody cares about Luca because he's not. It's not like he's a fighter or anything, anyways. So
Whoa. I mean,
let's just pick up with what happened.
technically.
You know what? No, you know what? You know what?
Ralph.
I will let my actions speak louder than my words.
Okay. All right. Well, we will see with that. So we're gonna go over two things really quickly. First of all, if you'll notice down below, if you're watching on a web browser, there are a few different links that are down there nowadays. For one, we do have Will, aka Luca, is going to be taking some notes for us and posting them up there so you guys can always see if you missed what happened last session or if you're new to the show in general. You can always pick up what's going on. You can always pick up what's going on down there, see what's. Oh, sorry. See what has happened in prior sessions. So we do have him taking notes for that, which is great. We do have all the character sheets down there, so everybody can see what's going on with the character sheets. You can see the artwork that Alarant have put together for us to make sure it's nice and beautiful. Make sure that all these characters are very well expressed, and a few other little things that you guys can kind of, go over, look over, whatever it is. But we're not here to talk about links. We're here to talk about Dungeons and Dragons. We're here to play some Dungeons and Dragons. So what happened last week? So last week we had an experience where all of your characters, for one reason or another, were given tickets to go see a show, a bit of an unusual show. You were invited to the Pyro Hydra, which is a nightclub that is controlled by one of the many Dragonmarked houses in this world. It's the house that has an entertainers guild. Usually, that this called the Pyro Hydra because of its pyrotechnics that it's known for, and then it always has five shows. And the last show is generally reserved for people of like great esteem, people that are known to be wonderful artists, and almost exclusively for members of that house, and almost never for members of another house. Well, kind of a strange show. There was both somebody outside of the house and a member of the other house was playing that final show, and it was incredible. You guys went and got to see the wonderful works of Dane. Dane was amazing. Like, wasn't it a great performance?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, no?
It was certainly something.
It was artistic.
It was artistic. So it was actually kind of funny because when I recorded that, I forgot to bump up the volume of the YouTube video I was playing to have that music in the background, which kind of was like a double-edged sword because one, you have to like seriously jack it up to hear it if you're watching that VOD. But on the other side, it's so quiet that I don't think they're gonna mute it on my Twitch, on the Twitch VOD that's up there now, which is pretty cool. So hey, it's so quiet they didn't mute it. So hey,
Got
win, call it a win, right? So after that was done, you finally got to meet with the performance performers. You guys got to show your adoration, your adoration for the ones that you enjoyed. But you were kind of forced to meet with Dane, which was wonderful because he's so incredible, right? And in meeting with him,
turned down autograph.
The thing was, he was such a humble artist, somebody that was just so easy to get along with. You didn't want to feel like one of those people asking for an autograph. So you all like were like, no, we don't want one of those autographs because, you know, we appreciate just the quality of art that you put forward. He also gave you some information that he somehow stumbled across. Somehow during one of his performances, he was able to hear a sinister plot being put together. It sounds bizarre. I know Odette was feeling
somehow.
A little... Yeah, somehow. I mean, you don't
somehow.
Know. You don't know how he did or didn't do it. But he came across this sinister plot where supposedly some goblinoids, some green bloods, were around and they have this plot to kill a member of House Caneth, which is the Creator's Guild, and it's one of the ones that are working on like the struts or whatever they call it, like the power pyramids that hold up the lightning rail that's controlled by Aaron's house, House to Orion. Now that is a lot to swallow, lots of weird names there, but you'll pick it up as we go along. You joined into the combat and there was two waves of goblins is what you've come across so far, and unless you guys have anything else you want to throw at it, anything you feel like necessary to stay?
No.
Okay.
No, I think you got it. Got it on the head.
Perfect. Then let's fade into combat. Oop, wrong one. That's funny. Let's fade into combat. Bam. Awesome. Okay, so here we are. Here is the combat. Where we left off, I believe, was at the top of the very next initiative, the top of the initiative to make things nice and easy. Make sure it's all centered in the right spot. We can see everybody here for you guys. Awesome. So, just a call to attention where all your characters are, if everybody can ping your appropriate character so we can see them. There we go. Thank you so much. And we're picking up at the top of initiative. Top of initiative being this new round of goblins that are coming in. Now, I did do you the favor of separating the goblins so you can identify which is which, the goblinoids, I should say. So the first wave that you were fighting were the red ones, and the second wave that that just came out the door, kicks through the door, is the blue ones that you see the little token on them. So starting off with them ends their turn. They kicked their way through the door, and they're going to start rushing forward. I believe literally the turn ended with... Yeah.
Them so, jumping in, yeah.
Yeah, yep. Them jumping in, and they're going to continue rushing their way forward. Here we go. And over here, we're going to have a few more of them moving. Boop, boop, boop. And they're going to start making a couple of attacks. Alrighty. So with those attacks being made, give me just a couple of seconds to make these attacks. One is going to be against you, Will, or Luca. And two are going to be against woman that is the target. So let me make those attack rolls. Here we are. Bam. First against the woman that is the target. Yes, I ported in my outdated macros that I'm going to have to update. And did them. The first one that is attacking against the woman target, actually, it is a hit. They hit the woman, and they actually do harm her four. Oh my god! That is a huge strike. So the goblin rushes forward and comes with a short sword, and he slices hard, and he actually cuts the woman deep, cuts her hard. She actually falls to the ground. She falls to the ground, bleeding and crying out in pain. Oh, she is not doing well at all. Oh my god, that is terrible. So that's what happens there. And then immediately after that, we're going to have an attack against you, Luca.
Mm-hmm.
And so the attack against your 18 AC falls very, very short. It is a miss, and so you do not get hit. As a matter of fact, the way it swung at you, it swung so low, it whacked against your legs, almost accidentally hitting that little girl that's between your legs.
Jeez.
After that is going to be... I thought there was another, and there is not. It is going to actually go to Luca's turn immediately afterwards. Luca.
Okay, so in protecting this woman... I am going to kill the goblin closest to me.
Mm-hmm.
With my longsword.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to kill it.
That is a beautiful attack against the one that's immediately to your left and doing 9 points of damage. Would you like to describe it, sir?
So as he comes up to me and swings at like that little girl, I throw my shield down in protecting her. And then as I throw that shield down, I come across and I literally just slit his throat right with my sword, my long sword, just right across his throat.
Beautiful. I just realized I need to drop this down a little bit, see the action. So it was this one right here that you just sliced and killed. And it was these two over here that just had moved up beforehand.
Correct.
All right, cool. That being said, okay. So after you is going to be Stalbor's turn. Stalbor, how are you feeling, buddy? How you feeling?
I'm actually fine. The arrow that pierced my skin is now laying on the floor as no blood or anything anymore. Can I see anything past this tent? I assume I'm going to have to walk around.
Why don't you do me a favor? Because if you want to do it as like a free action, I'll allow you to make a perception with disadvantage as like a free action.
Yeah. Got to see past the tent.
With your 16, actually, yes, you can see. You can see the huge amount of commotion, the combat that's still going, or at least you perceive it. You don't necessarily see it. The amount of commotion that's going down with the woman that you're trying to protect is. But you can actually see over with this, I'll draw a line for you, with this like line of sight right here, you can see that there is definitely commotion happening over in this direction. And you had before seen that, what's her name? Odette had run up into that area.
Yes. But can I? Do I have line of sight towards this area?
Not without moving, no. But don't forget, you can move before and after your actions.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm going to see what's going on and start running and yell to Mr. Deneath to stabilize her. I can return her life essence if this all goes poorly, but only if she still draws breath. Then okay. I'm going to, you know, I couldn't say it in a normal way or anything.
That and was then the I'm going creepiest to cast... way to describe healing somebody. I've
oh
never
yes,
heard.
I'm going
to
cast Frostbite on this one. Let's see if I can ping Frostbite.
Which one were you attacking?
This guy.
Perfect. Awesome. So your attack, so it's a saving throw, not an attack roll. Perfect.
Yes, I know.
No, I got it. I'll make my save.
My spells are set weird.
No, you're good. You're good. You're good to go. So I actually make my saving throw.
Okay. So detail-wise, nothing happens if you save.
Yep, I saved, so we're good to go. After your turn, it's going to be Odette's turn, whose name is still coming in funny. We'll see if we can fix that during the break. Odette, please go ahead.
Yep. I'm going to cast Booming Blade, which I should have been doing last game session, and I didn't.
That's okay. We can't expect perfection every time, right?
Make an attack action against that one right in front of me.
Awesome.
Do I hit?
That with your 11 chance to hit with the one directly in front of you. Let's see. His AC is way too high for that. He's wearing breastplate, and he's got dexterity and stuff like that. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but you're not very good.
Did I see the other goblins rushing?
Did you see what was that?
The other goblins rushing.
You did, actually. Yeah, you were able to perceive that. Yep.
Surely you'd hear them more than anything.
And
yeah.
Regardless of that, I am going to move.
He is wielding a weapon, so how do you...
I attacked him, and mobile, I thought it was just if you hit with the attack, but it specifically states whether you hit or miss.
Thank you. So you have the mobility feat, which means if you attack somebody, you are able to ignore attack opportunity from that person, and you did exactly that. And then how was it you were able to move so darn quickly?
I am in Blade Song, which is a feature of my class, and two, again, the mobile feat gives me another plus 10. So my movement speed is 50 right now.
It is, and you moved exactly 50 feet, so you're good to go. Just wanted to make sure that was understood. Thank you, and that is your turn.
Not a problem.
Okay. After you is going to be the little blue... Sorry, but did I go too many blue goblins last time? Oh, I went too many blue goblins last time. This is when the goblins kind of rush forward, attack that girl, and she kind of keels over in pain, and I did their turn a little too soon last time. I got excited to kill her. And now it's going to lead our way over to the guards and then the red ones. So the guards are going to, as I'm on my counter, this guard right here is still slumped to the side and relaxing. These guards over here. So this one is going to turn and attack the goblin that's adjacent to him, the one that's kind of flanking with Aaron, though we don't do flanking rolls. And he's going to make his attack roll. It is a miss, sadly. Goblin's not hard to hit, but he was not able to get it. This one right here is going to also attack at one of the other goblinoids. So he's actually going to shoot past, what's his name there, Luca, and make an attack at one of the little goblins. Mm-hmm. He misses as well. This one right here, kind of rushing up to stand over the woman, looks up at Luca and says, I'll protect the girl! And kind of like reaches down to grab the little girl underneath Luca's legs.
We still don't know if these guys are trustworthy.
They're guards.
Absolutely. They're guards, and they are trying to protect a child. My focus is on saving the woman.
Mm-hmm.
I nod to that. I don't really say anything. I'm waiting to attack, essentially. So I'm just like and okay. Waiting.
And he reaches down between your legs, grabs up the little girl, and starts to, like, move. He moves just past, what's your name there? Reich. Moves just past Reich. And so let's see, he was standing here before, so that's 5. Moves, use a little bit of his movement. 10, 15, 20, we'll call it there. And that's as far as he's able to get. And then, we'll get 2 more. There we go. So he's able to get this far away from the combat with the little girl in his hands. I'll throw a little token on there so you can see which one has the little girls. We'll just throw a net saying that he has it. Okay. After the guards' turns, which were wonderful turns, we're going to have the red guys, which is the... Oh, this guy gets attacked, the red guy, too. And he hits! And it's a great... Oh, wow, that's amazing. Cool. Sadly, the guy he's attacking is uninjured as of right now, but that's okay. He is going to attack him. And 7 points of damage is incredible. He very much injures the guy that's in front of him, which is good news. That guy is very injured. The red guy is able to return the favor. Now being his turn, he is has his melee weapon out now, makes his attack. Oh my god, critical hit. He actually gets a critical hit on the guy. I don't know if you remember, but this guard had taken damage before from as he was approaching the goblin with the hobgoblin with the bow. My apologies, the bugbear with the bow. He got injured approaching. And so he actually drops.
Ooh.
Guard is down. Ouch. It is now finally Reich's turn, who sadly, I'm sorry, Eric, you rolled terrible this yep. combat.
Yeah, I'm very last. So I do, however, have a gobbo right in front of me. Is this the one that you injured? Is this one injured? The one right in front of me? I believe he was the one that was hit last.
Nobody was injured.
All right, so let me go ahead and attack that goblin right in front of me, the one. It's right front left of me. So I'm going to hit him with my short sword. No, I'm not going to hit him with my short sword.
That was a sad, sorry miss with your short sword. Do you want to do anything else?
Yeah.
Bonus action, maybe?
Yeah, I'm going to spend one of my key because I do still have 2 key. Wait. To flurry of blows.
Okay, so 2 more attacks.
Attempt to attack twice. Cool. Yes. So first one here.
Roll your damage before you do anything else.
This is why you shouldn't be attacking with a broken sword.
Yeah.
And you do 6 points of damage. You injure him. However, he is still standing.
Yeah, doesn't finish him. All right. Then I'm gonna swipe him with my second flurry of blows.
Another beautiful chance. You don't even have to roll for damage. Feel free to do so if you'd like. And since it's the first guy that you dropped, would you like to describe it for me?
Yeah, so...
describe your whole attack routine so we can get a feel.
I swing my sword at first, which looks which looks like a wild swing to at the creature. But as it goes to block away from that strike, he opens up his defenses, and I strike him once in the shoulder to take him off his stance and then crack him in the jaw with a kick. Sending him down to the ground and unconscious, more likely.
Oh, my sound is apparently still peaking. I'm just realizing that right now. I will see what I can do to fix that. My apologies, everybody. It must be very annoying. Thank you very much, Eric. After you is going to be one of the NPC's turns, but give me a second to address this issue before I continue, because that is more important.
We can wait.
Yeah. Yeah, you can, yeah, that's right, you can wait. Sound. What can we do here? And why are you doing this to me? Why are you doing this to me, Skype?
Why, Skype?
La 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 la. Okay, I definitely lowered the volume.
You're tearing me apart, Skype.
Lowered the volume.
You might not be peeking on Skype. You might be peeking on your recording software.
Very, very possible. But I mean, is that you know, is that?
Because you're not peeking to us.
Yeah.
You're peeking to them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Them. I don't know which way around I am.
Well, I'm just gonna lower this down a little bit and see what I can do here. Yeah. La 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 la. Okay, that should be better. Okay, hopefully that's better. We'll find out whether or not it is, and we'll keep going. Sorry about that, Eric.
I'm done. So that's going to be, that's actually, I would like to move into the square of the now deceased hobgoblin. I mean, goblin. No, he's just regular goblin.
Okay. Mm-hmm. This one's going to
I'm the racist.
This one's going to...
We've had a few hobgoblins.
This one's going to make his attack as well. So, he's going to, move forward and make his attack, this time at the appropriate time. So he makes his attack, and he... oh, my apologies. I'm so sorry. My head is out of sorts. So actually, he does not move forward and attack Luca. Instead, what he does is he backs off. He immediately starts to run away. So he goes... makes his way over here. And that's his whole turn, making a dash action to run over there as quickly as he can. Awesome. All right, that is his turn. After that is going to be Luca's turn. Luca... at the beginning of your turn, the woman that was cut open is lying on the ground and looks like she's probably dying. She kind of like pulls at your leg and she's like kind of pulling at you like, you, come here.
I guess I'll lean in and listen to what she has to say.
The girl, she's not a girl. She's one of the binders. They're after the binder.
Wow.
And then she's like laboriously breathing, trying to.
So upon hearing this, I'm gonna like nod at her in a sense like I wish I could have saved you, but immediately I'm going to pull out my. Wait, hold on. I can move there. Perfect. So I'm going to move. I can move through her, right? Because she's on the ground, dying.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So 30 feet to here, and I want to attack that guard.
Okay. So hold on. Before you are able to get over there, before you...
not attack the guard. I'm sorry. I'm going to attack the goblin. I still don't know that the guard would have been doing anything sketchy.
Yep.
He's trying to protect her, all I know, so I'm attacking the goblin.
The goblin that went after him? Not a problem.
Yeah,
as
correct.
As you do that, this guard that's right here that you ran past, he's actually going to attack of opportunity against you.
Oh, if that's the case, then I'll attack the guard.
Yep, so hold on. Sure. So while you're still here, he's going to get the attack of opportunity against you.
He totally does it, and he's totally going to miss.
You think that. However, he does hit your 18 AC because he's not a schlub. He's a hobgoblin. What?
Yeah, we're pretty cool. Oh. I don't know if you heard.
Oh, I rolled max damage.
That's
max damage. That's amazing. Okay, so how does
good campaign, guys?
What was that?
Great campaign, lasted a long time.
Okay, there we go. So you took a nice heavy hit from that one, and you're able to continue your movement if you'd like.
Yep. So after I go there, I get hit. I continue to this guard essentially. I want to hit this guard with my longsword.
Okay, hold on one second.
I'll start with that.
So as you go to approach that guard, this goblin, they actually have the ability to dash as a bonus action. And that's how he dashed across the field. And then he uses action to prepare an action for anybody approaching. So he's going to attack you as well for approaching the other guard.
Okay, so we can prepare actions, just double checking.
Standard action to prepare for if somebody's coming at you. You can't change your point of initiative. But if you're like, I'm going to stand here and aim my crossbow for somebody coming into the room, absolutely.
You have to be very specific with it, though.
Yes, yeah.
You have to be very specific. I just want to know for future sessions.
However, and it uses your reaction.
It does use your reaction. However, sadly, he only beat the AC of a 15, which would fail a lesser person, but not this non-fighter.
No, definitely not. So I want to... So he's holding the little girl, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I want to attack him who is holding the little girl mm-hmm. with my longsword.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll start with that.
Like you get in morning rock.
Oh, and, that's a, that's and a good now hit. I want to use my maneuver to trip him and possibly knock him prone. So he has to beat a DC of, I want to say it's 8 plus my proficiency plus my strength. So 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, mm-hmm. right?
And that's a strength save, right?
A strength of 12, mm-hmm. plus I get an extra 1d8 damage.
I beat the strength save, but you do 9 damage plus roll your 1d8. No, it's not 1d8, it's 1d6, because you're only level 2. So you only get the 1d6 from your feet.
Oh,
it becomes a 1d8 at level 3.
Okay, I thought you said I get a d8. All right.
Okay, so if you want to...
Oh, all right, that's fine. That is fine, sir.
15 points of damage is ridiculous. Oh, I did not expect you to be able to do that. Okay, so you come rushing at this guy. So you're skirting around, running past one goblin. You take a hit to the side, and it's not a light blow. But you have, like... You have a course of action. You're dedicated to your cause. You go rushing past that one, seeing that the other goblin is prepared for you. You throw your shield up in time and catch that attack, you know, kind of like throwing him backwards a bit and off of his feet. And coming up at the other guard as he's kind of wheeling around to you know, face off against you. You come rushing up at him, and with your longsword, you slice down hard into his chest, pulling it out and slicing out one more time at his leg, literally cutting through almost the entire knee, collapsing at its side. And he flops to the ground with the young girl flopping out to the grounds next to him. Make me a perception check really quickly.
Absolutely.
Advantage.
All right, perception with advantage. Mm-hmm. Let me toggle that real quick.
And you're able to see very clearly now. She was dressed as a young human, but this is clearly way too angular features. Definitely does not look like a little girl. It definitely looks like this is an adult woman, a gnomish adult woman.
Okay.
Okay, so that is your turn?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to go to Stalbor next.
Can I see this lovely chap? Oh, wait, wrong button. This chap.
It looks like, because you were aware of the stuff happening over there, you have something directly in your line of sight.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Yeah.
I don't even think I could even get somewhere where I would. Well, might just have to kill Steel from Reich then.
Yeah, that's fine.
Oh no, what a horrible shame. Yeah, I mean, I can. Well, we'll see. I'll cast Frostbite again, so.
That means I make a saving throw.
Yeah.
Deck save, right?
It's not about the damage on Frostbite. It's not about the damage.
Sure. Say so. Okay, bam. Actually, I failed, and I take that whole 1 point of damage.
Okay, so, as Frostbite starts to freeze and numb him, he has disadvantage on the next attack roll he makes.
Absolutely. It's a beautiful spell. Thank you very much.
So it'll be handy. It's not for damage. I'm not trying to... I don't want to be a real fighter.
Do you want to move? Do you want to move with your turn at all? Or?
I feel like a little bit, but not like full movement. Like, sort of here to see what's going on, okay. But not everything.
Sure. And now we're going to have Odette's turn.
All right. I am going to attack that one with me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to use Booming Blade again.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe... I'm never going to hit anything ever.
Are you accepting you're not a real fighter? Are you accepting it?
If you accept like it, garbage. It was better. A two.
If you accept it, you'll do better. That's all I'm saying.
I'm going to be fantastic. Mm-hmm. I'm just warming up. Odette is used to dueling and formal fighting. This... barbaric display just isn't my... I'll catch up.
Sure. Sure you said. Sure you will. All right, who's next?
That's my turn.
Okay. So that is your turn. So now we're going to have the blue guy, the second round of blue guys next, which includes this one right here. So he is actually going to... he looks at... What's his name there? Reich? He looks at Reich, and Reich kind of like looks back at him. And this is like moments where they're like squared off for a second. And then he just like immediately bows away from Reich and uses the disengage action to move away from Reich and comes over here and attacks at Luca instead.
Yeah, that's fine.
At least he has disadvantage.
He does have disadvantage.
At least he has disadvantage.
Attacking Luca.
Gotta keep saying it.
Never mind him.
I applied my disadvantage, and your disadvantage did a wonderful job. You know what he rolled for disadvantage? I rolled a natural 20 and a natural 12. So you actually did save him with that disadvantage. I'm not joking.
I mean, save me or just help me?
You would have died.
You probably won't even notice, because it's probably just like his hands are a little numb, you know, a little icies. You think you're good.
No, you would have died. That's what would have happened. Canon, you would have died. After that is going to go to the orange people's turns. And so the orange people's, now with kind of like the rouse over, this one that's right here does not back away from Reich and will in fact attack him.
Oh, that's not the right thing to do.
Oh, I rolled a natural 20! I actually hit Reich!
Don't do that, man. That's not what you wanted.
20. I rolled a natural 20. That's amazing.
That's
he wouldn't lie about something like that, would he?
No.
That's not what you're about.
I don't lie about crits. I lie about everything else, but not crits. Okay.
You're better than this.
Oh man, I'm sorry, but I hope I don't drop you in one round.
Oh Jesus. He might.
Yeah, that hurt.
It's 13 points of damage. Holy crap. So with his hammer or whatever he has in hand, with this like large hammer that he has in his hands, you know, he kind of like catches Reich off guard because Reich is kind of like turning and watching the thing that just like bowed away and ran past, and he assumes this guard's next to him because this guard literally attacks that goblin just a moment beforehand but happened to miss. And then all of a sudden, as he looks back, kind of like feeling or seeing like strange motions out the corner of his eye, he turns back to get a catch of the hammer along the side of his head. I mean, it's going to leave a huge welt. He's already bleeding out of the side of his mouth, probably loosened a tooth. It was an intense blow on the side of his head. Reich felt that one. His ears are ringing. It was not very pleasant. Seeing this course of events, seeing how things quickly turns, this one that's right here is actually going to attack at the one that just hit Reich. Ooh, not that key. Is going to attack the one that just hit Reich. And he actually hits him. And is going to deal 4 points of damage to him. So he's injured, but not quite down. And any other guards. This one's just still kind of lying there on the ground, bleeding. And then this red guy, who happens to have survived, but he's injured. He's going to make his way down a bit. And he's going to line up his shot and attack at Luca as well. So attacking okay. Luca.
Sure.
I get a total of a 7. I miss you horribly. So Luca mm-hmm. does not get hit. And immediately after his turn ends, all of a sudden, this other one comes bursting out. This way up here. I'm going to scroll up over here so we can see it. This other one up here comes bursting out of the room that it's hiding inside and lines up his own arrow and goes to take a shot as well. He's going to attack Luca as well.
Damn.
Well, you're the one that's standing over their target, so...
Yeah, that's what happens when you're a real fighter, right?
Total of a 20. I do hit Luca.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to deal 5 more points of damage. Jeez, I'm rolling good against you, buddy. And that is the end of the baddies' turns. Next is going to come around to Reich.
All right. So I'm pretty hurt. I'm at 5 life. Mm-hmm. But I'm not the kind of guy
that
goes
Luca's
out.
At 10.
Did you just hit, you just took 5 more?
Yeah, right. I'm at 10.
So, what I'm gonna do, because I realize I have been missing something on the monk. So even if I make just a regular attack as a bonus action, I can make an additional unarmed attack. So I do get 2 attacks even when I don't use flurry of blows. It's part of martial arts. Pretty. I'm just reading it. So, long story short, what I'm gonna do. I'm going to start off with a short sword attack against this dude.
Okay.
Short sword, 17. Does that hit?
17 is definitely going to hit.
All right, so I'm going to do my damage to him, see how that helps. That is only 4 points of damage.
Luckily, he was injured before, but he still has his full health.
All right, so
he's not full health. He's still not down.
Full health. Jeez.
Then I'm going to...
Well, in D&D, if you have 1 health point or 1,000 health points, you're equally as good in combat, so...
Make an unarmed strike against him. Nice, dude.
That's a hit. It was a really good hit.
Alrighty. That's 7 points damage.
Awesome. Eric, drop that. Drop him for me. Tell me what that. Tell me what the damage is. Right. Tell me what it looks like.
So, yeah. So, I swing at him with the short sword. This time, actually slicing into him, as he's distracted by the minor cut I made there. I kick him once in the sternum and drop the pommel of my sword onto the back of his head, knocking him unconscious.
Awesome. So he's down for the count, and you're choosing to keep him unconscious instead of dead. You still have your move action. Do you choose to use it?
Yeah. Who's this person to the right of me? That's no one, right? No one important. Just
this right here. That is definitely nobody important.
Absolutely.
You're not real people like
that
us.
That is no one important at all.
Oh, that's Aaron, of course. All right, so I'm gonna move over here. Oh, actually, I can move over here without attack of opportunity, correct? Because it only happens when I leave their combat range. So I'm actually gonna move here to kind of go back to back with Luca.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
All right, and that's the end of my turn.
Cool. I'm just cleaning up the map a little bit, getting rid of some of these X'd out pieces,
gotcha.
So we're not being confused by them. All right, cool. And after that is going to be this goblin right here's turn. He is going to turn and attack at Luca.
Which goblin?
This one right here, sir. Left hand side.
Okay. Yep.
He's going to attack Luca. He's the one that had the prepared action against you last time. With a total of an 8 chance today, he's going to miss you horribly, so you don't have to worry about that. After his turn is going to be Luca's turn.
All right. So Luca doesn't like that he just attacked at me, so I'm going to finish him off real quick.
Mm-hmm. Take him down.
Oh, sorry. I don't have advantage.
Nope.
Forgot to toggle that.
Mm-hmm.
Do I hit?
Let's see.
13, probably not.
Yeah, 13 against this little goblin. You actually do hit him. You do, in fact, hit that guy.
And I kill him?
Yeah. Describe it for me if you'd like.
All right. So, what did he hit me with? A sword?
Yes.
Or try? So he tries to hit me with a sword, and as he does, it just bangs off my shield, and I kind of like peer over the top of the sword at him and just stab down right into his collarbone.
Awesome. Dropping this little guy. I'm just going to delete him from the map to keep things a little bit cleaner. Sure. Next is going to be Stalbor's turn.
I'd be paying attention. Actually, like, from there, I couldn't see half of the bad guys because of the statue. Mm-hmm. Sorry, miss. Okay. This guy, the hobgoblin archer, assuming he's an archer, he might not be. I'm going to cast Toll the Dead on him.
Mm-hmm.
Just have to get the button, but it's a save, so.
Okay, and the saving throw
and
is...
And he is damaged, so it should deal... It's a wisdom.
Okay. And it's what, the red guy you said? Yep. Okay, so it's a wisdom saving
red guy,
throw.
Yeah.
Ha! Ha! A total of a 6. So I fail. I fail miserably.
Alright, so I do a nice little D8. No, D12.
D12, sir. D12. Throw that D12 at me. One. Wow.
The bell was quieted this time because I noticed the look the last guard gave me.
Yep. That was not very intimidating there, sir. Awesome. And after Stalbor's turn, we're going to go to Odette. Odette, do something useful, mm-hmm. please.
I'm going to run up. And I'm going to cast Booming Blade.
You got this.
Nope. I'm going to run over here and check on this woman and see if she's okay.
That's not real. How does that happen?
Oh, man, this is rough. This is just so rough. Okay, so first is the guard's turn. This guard actually is still with you guys. And so he's seeing that this woman's bleeding out and that's your concerns, he'll actually rush up and look at Odette and kind of like look at her. Kind of like, do you want me to help with her? Do you want me to help with combat?
Oh, is he not turning against us?
No, he's on our side so far. I don't know if you heard when I was like, I can help.
Two of the guards have returned against
die,
you guys.
So.
Help me stabilize her.
Okay, so he will do exactly that. I'm going to roll a check really quickly and see if he just murders her by accident.
Good. Excellent.
Okay. So he starts trying to stabilize. If you choose to use a medicine check, he'll be able to provide you advantage. All right, Aaron?
Sounds good.
And this other one over here, kind of seeing that things aren't going well, he's going to slump himself up off of the ground, even though he's in a considerable amount of pain. He's going to slump himself up off of the ground and start trying to make his way forward. He's going to stay here, and he's going to take an attack at the one that Stalbor just tried to kill. And he actually does hit! Oh, wow, he actually does hit with this attack. I did not expect that. Ooh, I did the wrong buttons there. And he does hit, so let's see how much damage he does. Oh, and because Stalbor did that one, that left him with 3 health points left, so he kind of comes rushing forward. He's grabbing his side, pulling out the arrow as he's moving slowly, just in pain. He pulls out the arrow as he knocks the arrow and draws it, wincing at every moment of the way, and lines up a shot and lets it go with a shaky hand and everything, finds his target, hits the guy right in his side, and he's kind of, and just starts falling. So this one over here does drop as well.
I was wrong. I did make him see his own death, but it just took a little while.
All right, after that is going to his turn. He's just removed from combat, so get rid of that guy. We're going to get him. And that leaves us with this little blue one right here that already ran from Eric once. So he's going to stay here and continue on his target, trying to avoid Eric and attack William again.
That's fine.
And Luca. I Will, I am not lying to you. I got a 22. I rolled an 18 natural. Like, I am
No, that is absolutely fine.
I'm
that's
doing
okay.
Incredible against you.
Goblins know how to get between
I'm
the
not worried.
Armor plates. A jab.
So, you are taking hits left and right. You do take 4 more points of damage as he comes rushing forward and stabs at you, and he's able to get another nick in the side of your leg. You are bleeding from several areas and it's not looking so hot at the moment. But you've been in worse. You've been in worse. Situations have happened. After that is going to be, Yellow Guy's turn. He is going to make his way forward a little bit. Line up, so he pulls out an arrow, kind of like smacking against the wall that's adjacent to him, or something hard that's adjacent to him. And as he smacks it, the thing kind of like starts to sizzle and pop, almost like you would imagine like a sparkler would be. So it starts sizzling and popping, and he lines up the arrow and he knocks it up in the air. And as he lets loose, you can see that this goblin down here, the one that's adjacent to you guys and fighting, kind of like looks at the arrow with a bit of fear. Like, and I'm going to make that attack against Luca. Sorry, Luca. You know, you're just always there.
Shit happens.
Don't do it.
I actually do hit Luca.
Yeah? Okay. Luca's prepared for it.
So
he's being honorable.
Is he really?
I think we have one left.
So, I am down to 1.
5 points of damage as it sizzles and pops or whatever, and it slams into Luca, and it's in Luca's chest, it's in Luca's like the side of his armor, kind of like, caught between a couple pieces, barely stabbed into him, nothing like crazy, not didn't stab into him too far, but it was another nick into the side, and Luca's just like every time he moves, it stabs a little bit further, and he's in a lot of pain from it. But the thing sizzling and popping could both Reich and Luca make me a perception check, please? Luca with disadvantage.
Yeah, that's okay. Perception, you said, correct? Ooh!
Reich?
I'm trying to... There we go.
Did you pop out your character sheet?
Yeah, I have it out right now. I was just...
Alright, neither one...
Could I see? I'm pretty close.
Where are you?
I'm here.
Right here.
I'll let you make a perception check as well, that's fine. Oh, that's too far.
Just seeing them fail horribly, and maybe there's a chunk.
Why are you rolling with some modifiers there?
Oh, I assumed I had disadvantage.
No, you did not have disadvantage. But if you want to keep it, that's fine, whatever. So you got your 16. You're able to see that this thing's sizzling and popping, but somewhere down, about a third of the way down the haft of this arrow, there is some sort of like packet, like a metal tube that's like clung to the arrow itself, and it's sizzling and popping its way towards that. Could you do me a favor and make me a history check with disadvantage? With a normal history check.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Ooh, it's not often I'm going to do a normal history check.
Sadly, that is not going to be able to help you out. You do not know what it, you do not know what it is.
Well, can connect some dots. He might get the wrong conclusion, but,
Maybe.
Can I, for reaction, so I can probably, like, say, or probably more accurately, yell.
Sure, what would you say?
Get the arrow out.
Okay, it's now,
look at it.
sorry. It's now Reich's turn. Didn't
cut you off. All right. What side of Luca is the arrow in?
It doesn't really matter. You can grab it from where you are.
All right, I'm gonna instead, without saying a word to him, I'm just gonna grab the arrow and try to rip it out.
Nice.
So, what would I need to roll for that, or?
So you need to roll for me a dexterity check. No, sorry, a medicine check. My apologies. A medicine check.
Oh, damn it. I won't lie. Medicine is not the best out of those two skills. It's not terrible.
I'm rooting for you.
Punch it in.
This is what happens. You grab the arrow, and you try to pull it out, but as you do so, you're actually kind of twisting and whatnot, and you're hurting him even worse. Roll for me a d4 damage that you do, and you break the haft, meaning it's going to be much harder to get out.
I drop regardless.
Yep, so d4 doesn't really matter. You just immediately drop to zero health, and you are unconscious, Will.
Yeah. See, the thing is that Stalbor, knowing that there's Hobgoblin inside us, may immediately spring to the conclusion.
I'm on your side.
Ouch, that was rough.
I assume after he drops, Reich gives a look, and Stalbor's holds the spellbook, glares at him.
My character just puts his arms up in defeat, just damn it. I've done it again.
The worst part is, it's now Luca's turn.
Yeah, and I would have been able to second wind and be okay.
Luca, could you roll for me a d20, please? So a death save? It's actually on your character sheet. There's a button you can press for a death save.
I got it. Yeah, I fail.
I thought I might fail.
Times two. I fail times two.
Oh, no.
Eric, what did you do to me?
I just killed you. I was the death of you, man. I'm sorry. Jesus
Luca's
Christ.
Luca's not going to like Hobgoblins, let me tell you. If he comes back from this, he's not going to be a fan of yours.
We were boys.
Oh my god, Will, you might have character death right at the beginning here. It's out of my hands, literally. So, okay, first things first, up at the top of the map there, all of a sudden there's another, this is an actual Hobgoblin, unlike the guards that had been, there were guards that were pretending to, there were a couple of Hobgoblins that were pretending to be guards or whatever beforehand, and there were a bunch of bugbears, the archers were all bugbears. This is a Hobgoblin that is straight back, standing tall and proud, with his, deep reddish skin, his beautiful armor. He's got a wonderful weapon at his side, and he's holding a crossbow in his hands. He kicks open the door that he's in, and he comes out and immediately starts barking orders at all the creatures around. Finish this up! We need to get them! Get that girl! Let's go! But he's screaming this out in Goblin, so the only one that can understand it is Reich. Everybody else says, as he's screaming the Goblin language. And as he does that, he kicks open the door and he starts making his way down the battlefield, but he is not able to engage anybody quite just yet. Okay, wow. That was... now it's Stalbor's turn to see if Stalbor can...
So he's going to immediately, go over and go to push Reich out of the way, but he is not strong enough. So it's just sort of a more of a motion. And can I make a medicine check to try and stabilize Luca?
You most certainly can. You can try to make a medicine check to stabilize him.
Don't make it worse.
You do have a spell, mind you.
That's 1 minute cast.
But the problem is that he has has an explosive in him.
Oh no, I have yet to spare the dying. Yes. That's perfect.
You do something that can help me? I appreciate it.
Yeah, I'm just gonna... So in a sort of counteract to the sort of blacks and reds of the magic that he's been got, even Frostbite, it's a red spell that turns to ice. He sort of almost meditatively puts his hands on Luca and a white light sort of flows into him, letting him breathe again, even if the arrow is probably still in him, actually. But,
Nice.
We'll burn that bridge when we get to it.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Okay. So you do... Go ahead. So you cast a spell, you stabilize him, you're back down to zero death points. Eren, right as your turn starts up, right as you start being able to move and wherever it is you describe doing so, all of a sudden, fizzle. There is an explosion on Luca's body. It is not a very good one. Holy crap. It is literally boom. Stalbor and Reich, make for me a saving throw.
Dexterity.
Dexterity saving throw, please and thank you. Both of you guys succeed the saving throw. Luca automatically fails, obviously.
Right.
Ready?
I can stabilize you next time.
7 points of damage, fire damage. Both of you guys take immediately as the explosion goes off.
So I'm no longer stable, essentially, right?
You're no longer you're no longer stable.
Do we take half damage?
Oh, you guys take half of that, yes. Which is three, because you made your saving throw. This goblin does not make his saving throw, so as the explosion goes, he's kind of like looking at it frantically, and he's like, and he turns to try to run away, but as the explosion goes off, he happens to be on the side of Luca where the thing was stuck in, and it blows out that side. Oh man, it is going to leave quite the mark in poor Luca. Luca, by the way, you have 2 death points, not 1, from the explosion in your body. Back to 2. Back to 2. The explosion goes that way. The force takes the goblin and throws him forward. He smacks his head against the side of the wall. Between the charring and the smacking of his head, he drops. The little goblin over here is dead. However, also, that young looking girl has to make her saving throw from what happened. She saves as well. She does get charred and whatnot, but she does save as well and only takes half damage. Now it's Odette's turn.
Yeah.
And Luca's close to dead.
No, I'm fine, but my next turn will be trying to stabilize Luca again if he is still alive.
Okay. I am going to continue my plan of stabilizing that woman then.
The thing is like if Luca rolls less than 10 next turn.
Yeah. You got a 50-50 shot. You got a 50-50 shot.
Right. Help.
So Eren, you move. You're here, sorry, and you get to roll advantage on this medicine check.
Yep. Is 10 to stabilize, I think?
I think it is. I don't think it's. It's either 10 or 15. One of you guys can Google it really quickly.
Depends on how bad the wound is.
It's 10.
Yeah.
And then Eren, you still have your move if you would like. So she's stable.
So let's see. That was my action, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, 5, 10, 15, 20. Can I see this guy over here? Or one of these guys?
You can see both of them up there. The one with the yellow token and the one with the purple token. The one with the purple token clearly looks to be a lot more intimidating than the rest of them.
Alright.
And that's your whole turn?
30. I'm going to move up to him. I wasn't really counting how many squares I can use, but I can bonus action dash to give myself another 50.
Mm-hmm.
Because I have extra visual treat on, so I can move up to 100 squares, so I'm not really concerned about making it.
No problem.
All right.
Will that matter if Luca dies?
Well, he's probably fine.
Okay. So after that...
50 shot.
All right, so after that is going to be the this archer's turn, who's, again, kind of like drawing himself forward in a lot of pain. He's going to pull himself over here, line up his attack, and he's going to attack at what seems to be the boss guy. And here we go, make his attack roll. Wow. This guy both saved Stalbor, dropped one of the... He is doing extremely well. He actually... Yeah, and 5 points of damage to the man. Okay, 5 points of damage.
Does he happen to be a medic of any sort?
No. And that's his turn. So after that is going to... No, sorry, and then it's this archer down here who is also going to come out, seeing that the girl is stabilized. He kind of gets up on onto his feet, makes his way around over to, you know, makes his way around over to here, and we'll also line up an attack to shoot at the... archer that hit you from before, the one that's in yellow. Mm-hmm. So, however, his movement makes him to get over there. He's gonna make his attack roll. Bam. Misses horribly. After the orange turn is actually gonna be the yellow guy's turn. He is going to line up and attack back at that same exact guard that just attacked him. And he hits. These ones have the D8s. Oh! Oof. The guy takes 9 points of damage and is not doing well. This guard is actually in worse condition than the one that's been dragging himself around assisting you guys for a while now. So he is not doing hot at the moment. Oh my god. After the guard's turns, after that bad guy's turn, it brings us over to, let's see, he goes where? Was he taking off my initiative tracker? Mother effer. I put him...
No, he's lowered down.
Oh, no, yeah, I see him. He's at 11. Okay, that brings us to Reich's turn.
Okay,
He's just tiny on the thing.
Luca, I'm going to leave this up to you, because it's your life. I will gladly... I will gladly spend my turn trying to stabilize you, but there is always the chance I can make it worse.
I don't think you can make it worse than this.
You can roll a natural one again.
But like, this is potentially...
Have you trusted his roll so far?
I have a +2 to medicine, so I'm no slouch, but I am not exactly what I would call Mr. Medicine.
Don't forget,
you do what your character would do, sir.
You guys never used your insight that you started off with, correct?
Your inspiration.
Oh, inspiration. Actually, Eric did. Eric did too, no. I think.
Yeah.
Eric didn't. I don't think I did.
No.
Used it.
Yep. Only Odette and Stalwart didn't.
So, I'm going to try to medicine him.
You could kill him right now. Oh my god.
But he could save me. A +2 is better than a +0.
Oh, thank God.
Yes.
Oh, he's stable. Yes. Oh, my God, he's stable. Thank God.
Yes.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, Lord.
Go ahead, Eric. Go ahead. Describe it. Oh, my God.
I reach down, like, with the hands of, like, an old soldier. I patch him up. I look at you, like, trying... I look at Stalborn trying to look like, you know, like, very, like, you know, like, gruff and masculine, but I obviously look very sheepish as I take the rest of my movement action to just sidle away and go over to the boss guy.
Okay.
Actually, no, I'm going to stay back here because I am at 2 health right now, and so I could easily go down. I'm going to stay back here and wait until my next turn and attack him.
Next is Luca's turn, which sadly we have to skip. And before we fight this boss, I know that we want to finish up this combat and everything, so you guys can, you know, do other stuff or whatever. But why don't we take our first break now, knowing that Luca's going to live, unless the party TPKs. Knowing that Luca's going to live, thank God. I was afraid I was going to kill Will's character so quickly. Yeah. Knowing that Luca's going to live, why don't we take our first break, okay?
All right.
I think that's taken off as the worst fighter because I saved his life.
Yeah.
No. Stay. Someone does something worse.
All right, guys. We'll be back very shortly. See you in about 5 minutes.